Good morning and welcome back, Boardwalkers, to the art studio. I'm CB Mack, and today I thought we'd do a painting of a gorgeous moth that I have located on the post on our front porch. It's got some gorgeous coloring, autumn coloring to it. And I'm not exactly sure which kind of moth it is. It could be a Hercules moth. Or it could be a Fink's moth. But the colors on it are just fabulous. And although I can't really see it well, I have gotten a couple of still shot photos to use for reference. So I think I am going to try and paint this today. Okay, Boardwalkers, I apologize in advance. I thought I was filming when I had sketched this. But this is what the moth looks like that we're going to be painting today. Our reference photo that I'm using is going to be this photo. You can go ahead and snap a screenshot of it so that you can have it. And the supplies I'm going to be using today is going to be my Winsor & Newton Cotman field travel set. I'll list all the colors that I am using in it. I've pre-mixed up a yellow ochre and Payne's gray color for the wood grain. I've pre-mixed up a little bit of the permanent rose. You could probably use quinacridone rose and some burnt sienna. I've got a huge mix of the burnt umber, a huge mix of the burnt sienna, and then this little mix is a bit of the Payne's gray, I believe, with my cobalt, either my cobalt blue or my cerulean blue. I think it's my cobalt blue. But these are going to be the various colors that we use for the moth. And I still don't know what kind of moth this is. I haven't been able to get in touch with my biologist friends who would be able to tell me what this is. But let's get started with it. We're going to be using our Sharpie pen to put in some stippling effect today while we do our watercolors. I've got the mechanical pencil that I used on this. Our paper today is going to be the fluid watercolor paper with the cold press finish. My little 8x8 inch block, which is the 20.32 centimeters by 20.32 centimeters. It's the acid-free easy block, 140-pound paper, 300 GSM. And I have it taped down around the corners of everything because I want a nice little crisp edge border on this. So, let's get our background color in first, which is going to be our wood grain. And I'm going to pre-wet this. I'm going to use the wet on wet technique so that I can really get a nice background in here. And have some nice blended edges. Come on, photo. We're going to use our part of my wing. I don't want that wet. I don't want that section wet. I want the outside. Alright, we're just going to do this in small stages. Alright, my wood grain. My technology is not wanting to work well today. Alright, and I'm going to put in this blue-gray color. For an undertone and a shadow. We just want it to disperse really nicely. Just going to use it on the edges right in here where we've got the shadows really underneath. Now I'm using the wet on dry technique right here under these two sections because I really don't want it to run over these little legs and feelers of this moth. And then we're going to do another wet on wet section right under here. Now I'm applying this water. It looks really heavy and there's a lot of water on it. But the reason why I am doing that is because we are having such warm weather here still. Nope, I used a cerulean blue. Okay. That's okay because this is going to be darker in here. So we'll go with a darker blue. We're not going to panic. It will just give us a darker shadow right under here, which is what we need anyway. So, don't worry about the color choices. And this is going to give us a nice little texture with the way that it's doing. We don't mind having back runs or back washes on this section of our painting because it's going to add some interesting texture to our painting. Come on. Alright, now I'm going to go in with some Payne's Gray. And we're just going to streak this in. Because we want a little bit of that texture. And I'm leaving these pencil lines a little heavy. Because with this darker color, they're going to not be seen real well. And if they are, it's okay because it's going to make these ridges of where our wood is. So we're just going to pop this in here. We're going to do this. Now, my brush is slightly dry. That's the color we used last time. My brush is slightly dry, and if we have a dry brush effect to it, it will be okay because that's going to add you some texture. Yep, I went over that filler. Let's get my paper towel and damp that out because we want that to stay white. And we do not want this really staining color in that section. All right. Now, if my reference photo would stay still. All right. So, we're going to hold our brush on the edge. We're just going to let it graze the paper. Just graze the paper with it. If some of it gets on there, fine. If some of it doesn't and it leaves some spaces, that's all fine and well because we just want the look of wood behind there. Now, we can throw in some brownish color. Drop that in. Glaze it over this part. Give some added warmth under there, like it shows in our photograph here. We're going to drop it in here while this is wet, and this is going to blend together with some browns and streaky effect, like the wood. Some of it will turn brown and some of it will be a brown gray. The paper's still wet, so it's going to give these wonderful different variations of color. And we're still not worried about everything being covered completely. We want those weird streaks for the wood. This is the one time it's okay for your streaks. See how that dry brush is? It's laying down a little bit of color, but it's also making those streaks on the paper so that it makes it give that wood texture. Now, the wood grain on this one is going to be a little bit lighter. So I'm going to go in with some yellow ochre up at the top here and bring some of that color up and then just dry brush that in here. I'm going to go over these pencil marks. I'm still going to leave these pencil marks. I don't mind the extra pencil marks in my artwork. Sometimes it helps give definition to my piece. And it's something I don't mind. So if you don't want it in yours, just remember to erase your drawing a little bit. Erase those marks if you don't want them showing as much as I have them showing on mine. You have permission to make the painting like you want it. You can take some creative license with it. All right. Let's see. Now, this corner, bottom corner, it's all white and light with some metal But I think what I'm going to do today is I'm going to take creative license and I'm just going to darken that in. Just really dark. Make me a dark edge. Give some dramatic contrast right here. And just darken this post in. Put a dark edge on this post and blend this out. And there we go. There's our background. And if you notice, when I tilt it, the only section that's really wet is this corner over here. This right here is already bone dry. That's how dry it is. I'm going to let this sit and dry a little bit more. And while we're letting this dry, could I ask you if you're enjoying this video? Could you share, subscribe, and click on that thumbs up, like button? It makes a huge difference to the growth and the support of my channel. And I will also put descriptions of the various art supplies that I'm using in the description video below for some affiliated links. That just means I'm awarded a small commission for purchases made through them at no additional cost to you. All right. Let me see if we can figure out if someone knows how to get iPhone to quit timing out. If you could put the directions or a link of how you do that in the comment section below, that would be very helpful for me. I've been struggling with trying to get these phones to stay up properly. All right, we're going to start in on this moth. And I think what I'm going to do, if you can tell on this moth, it's got some light reddish brown highlights all in it. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go in with my burnt sienna, except where these white striped highlights are. Now, I have not put anything down to keep those protected. I'm just going to paint around them. So I'm going to use some negative painting technique to just paint around that and keep those areas white. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here and I'm going to just lay in some of this wash. As an underpainting. Bring it in through here. Remembering to skip these areas where we've got these bits of white bands. Just paint them in. Right, I do not see on this big wing here, I don't see very much white. And so whatever little bit of white, like these little stripes, I can go back over with either my white watercolor, the Chinese white or the titanium white, or I can use the Dr. PH Martin's bleed proof white at the end when we're doing the details. Now, I do have to be careful of where this yellow is on these tips. So, I can leave the white of the paper up here for this section. But now for these sections, I'm going to need to leave the little circles areas right in here for the yellow. But I can still continue to lay down all this wash right in here to give it a warmth. And warm it up. Now I'm just going to go to about right there because I need to leave this corner for the... There's the circle part right there, which is a little white, and then this little section right up there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right close to it and then just fill in the rest of this with just a really light wash. We're just going to go in with this little light wash because we want to add a little bit of warmth. We want the colors to blend in. The rail. Move over this way. Now this is all really dark, but there are some little bits of that reddish tinge in there. So I'm just gonna, and then right along in here you've got that nice red tinge. So I'm going to just drop it in. Don't be afraid to just do an underpainting and drop it in with the watercolor. You're working light to dark, so it's going to work out okay. All right, now I did boo-boo a bit. Got a hurried ahead of myself, and I went outside my blue there. Just take your brush, a wet damp brush, run it across it, dab it if you need to. We can go back in with some blue gray and touch that up, and we'll be all right. Red sienna, burnt sienna in there, that orangish color, orangey brown. We're gonna hit this again with a little darker, a little, it's not as watery as the first coat. It's got a little more pigment in it, and we're just gonna bring it on down. right, so we're back again, and I've added some darker highlights to it. My camera was not filming when I thought I had hit filming. But now we're going to continue to add in a few more, double check our highlights and our darks. For our highlights, I'm going to add some Dr. P.H. Martin's Bleed Proof White on the different areas here to touch those up, to make those pop, and to give that feathered texture on this brownish section of the wings. We'll give that fuzzy texture to it. And then I will also be darkening up these two areas and this area over in here with some stripes. And then we'll double check these wing areas and make sure those are dark enough for our moth. So, make sure my brush is clean. I'm going to dip into my clean water and tap into this Payne's Gray. And I'm going to use the Payne's Gray for my darkest darks. And we're just going to brush some of this on here to make these a little bit more dark. Bring that across this little section here. And darken up this little circle here. This little area. And then we're going to put in our vertical stripe on our brown in here. Touch up some of these darker darks. Make sure all these darker darks are dark enough, because when they lighten up, they will lighten up. They will lighten up to a paler black, almost a gray color. But that's pretty much all we need to do. I do need to hit some dark over here on this corner. On this wing part. And do some just faint smudges. Oops, I had to go back through there and pull that one out and hit some more stripes right in here, another stripe. Just about. I probably need to darken up this patch over here and put a little bit of dry brush across there to darken this shadow up right in here. Then we can top us a white highlight. highlight right here on this tip. Get in here with a little bit thicker paint. Make this just a hair darker. Coming across this. Maybe right in there. I might need to go back over that with some more brown, actually. And put me a... And it looks like I need to do a small... teeny tiny bit of black right in there. Connect that a little bit more. Put in our little stripe of dark here. Just want to tap it in there to give it that fuzzy effect. And then maybe put a little bit right in here. And smudge that out with my fingers. Smudge that out and give that a little bit of a fuzzy texture right there. And I think... I am pretty pleased with the darks. Now the dark right here on my wood is probably not as dark as it could be. So if I put a dry brush effect and just hold my brush and streak across through here, darken this up some. That will make that pop right there. And I can come back down here with some more streak of black and gray for this line down here. Come through here with a few streaks and just streak that up a little bit more. Then that will give us our extra textured section right here. That will give us our textured section on our wood. And I think that about does it for our... Add a little bit of dark. I can get it with just the tip of this brush. Need to make a nice little tip and then dab it on my kitchen towel and just do the slightest little touch across this feeler and leg to give a little bit more contrast for that leg. And I think we've about got the darks where I want them. And go in here and fix this mistake. Just scrub it out. And that takes that little bitty bit of black out. Let's bring our reference photo back up. All right, now I just need to hit a couple of little bitty spots with some white. And I'm going to use this number 03 Winsor & Newton line brush, round brush. It's a round brush, but I use it like a little line brush. And open up my PH Martins. Now, I'm going to drop a drop of water in there, a couple drops of water in there, and just roll that around. And get that to where it loosens up a little bit. And run it across the top of my PH Martin here. Loosen some of that up. Now, I just want the slightest little bit of white. To brush in here. Like little hairs. Across this area, across here, and I'm just barely tapping that on my brush, on my painting. Just two hairs and some air, as Bob Ross used to say. And that will give you that little white texture. We're going to do that everywhere where it's looking like we have some white texture on this area of the brown. Brush here. I got a little too much on the edge there, so I can get this feathered out. Feather texture looking like going here. Go across the tip right here where we need that white dot, and then on some of this feathered area right in here. Hit that white spot there. And then around all of these little bitty bits of black, we're just gonna feather it in. Just a very little bit. Not a whole lot. Down here on the bottom. everywhere. We've got the white going here, running across. And see how that makes that wing just pop with just little bitty feathery texture. All right, we've got that. We can go right here across the top of everywhere where the black, where the dark meets something, pretty much. We could add some wispy little texture to it. Feathery texture. And make it fuzzy looking. On there, because it's not popping right really well right in here like I want it to. What? I'm starting to get a little too heavy. Go back down to little fine little lines. Coming across here. And just really get that little teeny tiny texture going. Those stripes across the back. See how fuzzy that texture looks? We're trying to match that in our sections right here. And I think we pretty much got it. Let me see where else we've got to go. Maybe a little bit right here around this section here. And right around this black down here. And then just a little bit more down here toward this bottom one. And then over here on this side, we need to get some dry texture going right here. Now my brush is starting to dry out a little bit, so now I can add some of that really fuzzy texture to it by dragging my brush across. And then you go right in here. And then hit the highlights right here along this edge. About you guys, but I'm thinking that we're about done. Come across here a little bit. And make sure my texture over here is looking a little okay. think we've got that. I think that's it. Hold these up together so you can compare. And let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any questions on anything that we've painted or techniques that we've used in this process, please feel free to post them in the section below. I do read each and every comment, and I do try to answer all the questions that are posted. You also can follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and I look forward to seeing you guys again next week. Goodbye for now.